Gwenny. Oh my God. Hey you guys, I am super excited today to watch a video with you about Gwyneth Paltrow. This video is all about Gwyneth Paltrow and her guide to everyday skincare for the series that she did for Vogue, Beauty Secrets with Vogue. And this is going to be really good because Gwyneth, as we know, has got her own skincare brand, Goop. And not just a skincare brand, Joni, it's a lifestyle brand. Yes, lifestyle and wellness. And I personally have watched her series on Netflix, which I really found eye-opening. If you haven't watched it, watch it and you'll see what I mean. And I'm not saying any more, no. But go and watch that, that's good for you. Now, Gwenny has got Goop and she should know all about skincare. She's an actress, I'm sure she did modelling, whatever. She was part of the Brat Pack in the day and she is 48 and will be 49 September. So you think at that age, now at that age and you've got your own skincare brand, that you must know what you're doing. But I have to admit, when I was sent this, all these messages and all these texts coming to me, you've got to watch this, you've got to watch this, you've got to do a reaction to it. I thought, wow, what is going on? So I have watched it and I did think, from Vogue, is this an April Fool's thing? Is this an April Fool's trick? Or a joke? What is going on here? I think it came out on the 1st of April and I really was like that, wow. So we will have a look and see what I am talking about, but this is fun. Be holding on to your seats for this one.
Hi, I'm Gwyneth Paltrow and I'm back for my second Beauty Secrets. I'm gonna walk you through a little bit of my daily routine and all of the products that I love, and you can see how it has evolved. The first thing that I do in the morning, well, after I brush my teeth, is make my morning smoothie. This one has some nut milk and some almond butter, some good quality protein powder, just a little something to always make sure I have a little protein before my morning workout.
Really quickly, she's wearing makeup. She is wearing definitely eyeshadow. I can see it, natural nude color, but she's wearing eyeshadow and she's wearing mascara. And she looks like she's got a little bit of, to me, a bit of blush on and some maybe lip gloss or something, but there is makeup on Gwenny's face. That's the first thing I'm thinking, and her hair's down. When you're going to do your face, you don't have your hair all beside your face. No, you don't. So that's the first thing I'm going to say. And I thought it was funny when she had a drink of that protein goop, whatever it is, drink that she's got. I thought it was really funny because, and she went as if, ooh, that doesn't taste as good as I remember. So just saying that to you, but she's wearing makeup.
Which is really part of my wellness routine. I believe that beauty and wellness are inextricably linked, is the dry brush. You just want to have a dry brush that has a little bit of resistance to it, that's not too soft. And basically what you do is you start at your toes and you gently brush your skin all the way up the body. So, and always towards the heart. So I'm doing it on my arms now, and you can do it towards the heart this way and upwards on the stomach. And it really helps with circulation and exfoliation, among other benefits.
Now I'm going to say, just about the dry brush, right? Would you do that every day as your routine? No, no way, Jose. And also, you know, look, who wants to have a dry brush and, you know, go like that? You know, improve the circulation? Yes, it does. Would you do it every day? No. Is there other ways to get the circulation? Yeah, get a towel, get a really good towel and go like that. But I think this is funnier saying that. It lets me think, is it Getox Ultimate Dry Brush at £18? Is that part of the Goop range and she's got a whole whack of them made and she can't sell them? Just thought I'd slip that one in there. But I'm going to say, I'm not here to slag Gwenny. I actually do like Gwenny. I really loved her in the Iron Man movies. I mean, acting beside Robert Downey Jr., lucky woman. That's all I can say.
One of the most critical parts of my morning routine, for me anyway, is my meditation practice. So I do something called transcendental meditation every morning with my husband. It's a really nice way to start the day, just centered and kind of letting the mind empty out. And then we go from there. I really find that creating a practice or a ritual out of something makes it so that you're definitely investing in yourself for that time every day. So the next part of my morning routine.
Well, I love that. I love that. I think meditation is fabulous. And if you haven't got into it yet, get into it. Don't be lazy. Get into it. It's really good. I liked how she said that and does it with her husband. That's really nice. I do like this part. I do. I think this is really good, this bit. Mm-hmm. And health, wellness, it all goes hand in hand.
Important to me, I can't live without it. It is our Goop Glow Microderm Instant Glow Exfoliator. I'm a massive exfoliating junkie. It just gives you this incredible smooth finish. Looks like that. Okie dokie.
Stop it. Right, let's look at that quickly. Goop Glow Microderm Instant Glow Exfoliator, 50ml, not a lot for 112 smackaroonies. You can actually get a little one, 15ml. How much is 15ml for 38 quid? Oh dear. But here's the thing. First of all, do not scrub in the morning. Look at every video I've talked about exfoliation, and you should only exfoliate gently at night before you go to bed. So that is not good. She's doing that in the morning. Think about that. You're going to exfoliate your dry skin off in the morning. You've already cleansed it. I'm assuming that she's cleansed her skin. We couldn't really see her what cleanser she's used. Mm-hmm. And she also, you know, we don't know. She definitely is wearing makeup. But anyway, she's put that on. It didn't look to me as if it'd been all over her face, because it's got things in it, alumina, some mineral scrub agent, that's definitely going to make the skin go pink, and it will make her skin go pink. Uh-huh. So I'm telling you right now, what I can see in Gwynnie's skin is that she's got dry skin. There's a bit of lining going on here in the forehead and here. This is interesting to me. So I don't think she was a big, massive Botox fiend in her day, which is good, right? And there's lines here, all normal for her sign, for her age. But doing this very expensive Microderm Instant Glow Exfoliator before you go out to the environment, make your skin sensitive, sun sensitive, take away, strip off your natural oils. No, 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 no. You would not do that in the morning. No way, Jose. This has got a few ingredients in it I want to talk about. Glycerin, which is star ingredient. So that's good. It's got a good fatty alcohol, cetyl alcohol, great. Glycolic acid. Now, I'm going to tell you, I am a big fan of glycolic acid, because glycolic acid has got a very small molecular size and can travel down the epidermis to affect the dermis. So it will slough dead skin off. It causes a natural exfoliation, glycolic. It's really good. But again, using it in the scrub idea and in the morning, it's not a great idea. There's a couple of things in here, actually. Quartz, I'm just having a look. And the more I look at the ingredients, I'm going, oh, this is scary. So it's got silica, alumina and quartz in it. Wow, this is quite an aggressive scrub. No, I wouldn't recommend this even for her own skin. Wow, I can't believe I'm saying that. This is not a product that I would recommend to Gwynnie if she was my client. This, for sensitive dry skins, it's going to make them more sensitive and more dry, and you would not use it in the morning. So there is a couple of good. Glycerin is great, fantastic humectants in this. Obviously it's got vitamin C, which I think is great as well. That's another thing it's going to exfoliate. It's got squalene in it. Number 8 is squalene, brilliant. So there is a few antioxidants in it, which is great, but not in the morning. Not in the morning. And I think you'd be okay with this if you had normal to oily combination skin, you can get away with it. But she's definitely veering on the dry side with her skin. So this is really scary.
I am going to apply Vintner's Daughter. This is an unbelievable serum. I love the way it smells. And you just put a couple drops on. It's incredible to know that there are clean, non-toxic products that are really efficacious and really work wonders on your skin. Next.
Do you know what? I've came across this Vintner's Daughter before. Vintner's Daughter. Mm-hmm. I'm just trying to think who it was, the celeb. Was it Miranda Kerr? This is all smacking to me a little bit of a Miranda Kerr type feel to it. Even her good glow a little bit. Yeah, maybe they're pals, Miranda Kerr and Gwynny. I think they probably are. But this is a botanical serum. It's called a serum, but it's very expensive. It's 175 quid for 30 mil. Another expensive product. Uh-huh. Really quite expensive for that little serum. It is. It's got good antioxidants. It's got grapeseed oil, number one ingredient, and it's got hazelnut oil, good emollient. It's got a few volatile essential oils, which are not great for sensitive skin. I'm going to put it out there, okay? I'm looking further down. Rose oil, it can be sensitizing to some people, but it'll make the product quite nice and smelly. Uh-huh. Carrot seed oil can also cause sensitivity. Wow. But it's got evening primrose, which is skin soothing. It's like a mixed match of things. I have talked about this before. What I think's funny is there's a lot of oils in this, right? So she's done a microderma or a scrub, she's exfoliated, and then she's put on an occlusive. This is not right, okay? When you take away your dead skin, right, to stop, you need to hydrate it before you put an occlusive, because this that she's putting on will not let anything after this absorb into skin, right? So I need you to think about that. Occlusive, when it's oils, just puts a seal on the skin. Yes, occlusives are definitely great, but you have to hydrate the skin first and then put the occlusive on top. I truly think that's the way to go. And I'm surprised that Gwynny's done this with this serum. So nothing's going to penetrate after this easily because it's an occlusive. I'm just pointing that out.
Every day, this is like special occasion. Say you're doing a photo shoot or you have a really important Zoom or maybe you had a bit of a rough night. So these, Jillian Dempsey, she's a fantastic makeup artist, and she has these hydrating eye pads. You open up this nifty little packet, which is, I'm not strong enough to open. Okay, I got it. Sometimes I walk around the house with these on. My kids make fun of me. What else is new? While I'm letting them kind of soak in and doing email or whatever, I get the Jillian Dempsey also from her, this sculpting gold bar thingy. And you turn it on, it vibrates. Don't get any ideas. I was not a person who ever had a skincare routine as a teenager. My daughter does, but I was very much a tomboy. So this whole skincare thing has come to me later in life.
So we'll just talk a bit more. First of all, the eye, Jillian Dempsey Hydrating Eye Mask, I think they sound good, I do. But I would only put that on top of skin that's cleansed 100%. I would not put eye masks like that, that are trying to feed nourishment and moisturising and antioxidants into the skin. I wouldn't put them on top of a product, meaning I wouldn't put on something first and then eye pads on top. The eye mask should go on to clean skin. There is a couple of star ingredients in this: glycerin, vitamin E, and sodium hyaluronic acid. So there is good things in this. I do quite like it, the Jillian Dempsey. 55 quid for the eye masks. Yes, worth a try, but you have to put it on top of clean skin. Gwynny, okay. I'm surprised Jillian hadn't told you that. I'm sure she has. But then this gold sculpting bar, I mean, you know what I mean? It's a glorified jade roller. 185 quid. Come on. Come on. Right? Some people will think, oh, that's fine. I can buy that. It looks great. But you can't, first of all, she's pushing it onto the iPad thing. You can't, I've said this before, formulations get into skin or ingredients get into skin because of the formulation of the product. The roller is not going to push the product into the skin. Okay, that's the first thing. 85 quid for a glorified jade roller. I am not a massive fan of jade rollers. I know people are going to slate me for that. I am not. I much prefer a gua sha. The Jade Roller, it's a nice kind of feel to it, but the Gua Sha really can get to work if you do the Gua Sha movements, you know. So I do love the Gua Sha, obviously. And I've done a link about it before, you can see up here. But the Jade Roller thing, nah. I don't think it's as good. I think it's a trend, a fad, whatever. And for estheticians like me, they'll tell you what they think about it, hopefully, and it's true. So Gillian Dempsey, gold bar at 185, no way Jose. I'm having a look at her skin. I'm going to tell you, the more I see Gwynnie's skin, I can tell right now she's got sun damage here. 100% got sun damage on her chest area. Definitely, she's very freckly. I do think there's dehydration going on. That's just, don't get me started. But there is dehydration. I can definitely see that on her skin, on her, definitely her forehead. I think that. So she's got dry, dehydrated pigmentation issues in her skin.
People always ask me, you know, if I want something that's a clean, non-toxic product that really works, that I want to buy at the drugstore, what should I get? And I always say Weleda Skin Food. They make this super rich, fantastic moisturizer. I think my mom, you know, we both tend to have dry skin. We have similar skin. But she's very low maintenance. Like, she's probably even more low maintenance than I used to be. Now I'm a little bit higher maintenance. But I think what I learned from her most is just to be comfortable with yourself. Just be comfortable in your skin. And you know, that she was kind of a less is more in terms of makeup and stuff, and she definitely passed that on to me.
Right, quickly, this toxic thing, I hate that green, you know, I don't hate it. I like to think of products as being really good and formulations being really good. 100% think some of that wording is a bit not so right, toxic and all that. That I hate that scaremongering feel to people saying stuff like that. I don't like that. Gwynnie is using the Weleda Skin Food Ultra Rich Cream, which is $12.50 for 75 mils, good price, but drugstore. And I'm going to tell you right now, I don't like this formulation. I've had a look at it, and it's got sunflower seed oil, which is good, but it's got lanolin, it's okay, sweet almond oil, but then it's got beeswax, it's got a couple of beeswaxy stuff. That's why it feels ultra rich. It's got wax, it's a waxy feel to this one, which thickens it up, makes it a bit higher in the, you know, thickening. It's also got alcohol. Number 6 one is alcohol, which is drying. So the formulation of this isn't great to me. The only, I'm trying not to swear through this video, it's not been easy. Glycerine is the only true star ingredient in this, I do think. And it's even got essential oils at the bottom, which are really, people can be sensitive to them. They really can. So I'm not really loving this. I think it's an old fashioned, waxy, oily moisturiser. And I'm surprised. But wait a wee minute. I'm missing the point here. The point is that she's already put an occlusive oil in her face. And then she's put this occlusive oil on her face. Then she tried to put moisturising agents from the eye pads, which will not penetrate that vintner's daughter. Oh, that sounds awful, that. I just realised what I said there. Oopsie-daisy. Oh, I wish we could scrub that wee bit. Anyway, an occlusive oil and then put on the eye masks to try to get the nourishment for the eye masks into the skin. And then put on this ultra rich cream on top. None of this makes sense. This is not going to do a thing now getting into her skin. It's not. So, oh dear, I think we better carry on, Joan.
Sunscreen brand called Unsun, and it's a 30 SPF. You know, there are a lot of really harsh chemicals in conventional sunscreen, so that's a product that I really want to avoid, that, you know, isn't certified by the EWG, and which is a great website, by the way, if you ever want to understand how clean a product is. You can go check that out on their website, Skin Deep. And I'm not, you know, I'm not a sort of head to toe slather of sunscreen, but I like to put some kind of on my nose and the area where the sun really hits.
Gwenny. Oh my God. Oh my God. So just saying this to you, Gwenny's skin type, okay, is not dissimilar from mine. And this is total that she's been saying there about sunscreen. And I'm sure this is one of the things why somebody wanted me to see this. Uh-huh. So let's just talk about this, okay? For herself, for Gwenny herself. And she's beautiful looking. You will have to look at her. I think she's a gorgeous looking woman. I really, truly do. Looks great for her age, okay? But really giving wrong information out there. And that has annoyed me a bit. That's annoyed me a bit. She has got skin type 1 to 2. I'm not going to go into all that today, but what I'm going to say to you is that we produce melanin, and there's two types of melanin in our skin that gives our skin its colour and our hair its colour for everybody, right? There's two types. One is pheomelanin and the other is eumelanin. And people with red hair, and I was that person, had more pheomelanin. And the pheomelanin is like not a great melanocyte. It's not a great producing pigment, because pheomelanin doesn't do enough coverage to really, really protect you well from the sun. If you've got more of the eumelanin, which is like the brown black pigment that produces that in your skin, the melanin color, that is really the one you want to have when you really think I can take sun with not too much hassle. But anyone that's fair, she's fair, can tell really with her eyebrow colour, and I've got mine tinted incidentally, but I'm very fair and I used to have red hair. So Gwenny and me have both got more of the pheomelanin, which is not the very successful melanin pigment, or okay? And what that means is that we are prone to freckles, and I've got them too. I've got freckles the same as Gwenny, but also what it means is that you are prone to basal cell carcinoma. And this is why this has annoyed the hell out of me, because I've had it here. I don't know if you can see this, but I've had basal, and she's mentioning just where the sun hits in the face. I've had it, is it here? Yeah, there you go, there. Basal cell carcinoma on my arm, and I'm checked every 6 months for basal cell carcinoma, which is a form of skin cancer. So this is nonsense. This is now agitating, a little bit agitating me. Calm down, because you have to put sunscreen all over the bits that are uncovered when you're out in the sun, and especially if you're working at home, working with this light that's hitting our faces from our devices, you need to wear sunscreen and put on loads of sunscreen on your face, neck and décolleté, whatever is showing here. You've got to do it, or else you can be prone to this skin cancer, form of skin cancer. So this is really wrong what she's saying here. And I'm sure, if not, I haven't read all the comments, because honestly, I'd love to have the time to do that, but this is bad. Okay, so really, I'm going to make a video next week or the week after again about sunscreen, but I have made them before, and definitely, you know, get that to tell you how much to use, but you really got to put it all over, okay? And it should be the last thing you apply as well. I'm just putting that out there. The Unsun one, mineral tinted sunscreen, SPF 30, 25 quid, 50 mils. Yes, it sounds fine to me, because it's got two main ingredients that I do love in a mineral sunscreen: zinc oxide and titanium dioxide. So I do think Unsun is a good one. That's maybe the best product she's used here. Oh dear. So I hope that's explained a little bit further to you. I don't want to slag her, but that is worth a slagging off, Gwenny.
Glow lotion. So this is like a light moisturizer that you can put on. It just gives your skin an amazing little pick-me-up, just a nice glow. I really wanted to start making beauty products because at the time there really wasn't a lot available that was kind of beautiful, high quality, non-toxic products. And there were sort of clean moisturizers that you could find at the health food store. And then there were all of your conventional ones. And
well, I don't think I can listen to anymore. No, I can't. First of all, she's put on her Goop Glow Lotion, £52 for 50 ml. She's put that on top of whatever, how little sunscreen she put on. That is absolutely wrong. You need to put on the sunscreen last. So all your things that you put on sunscreen, you know, you should put cleansing your skin, then putting on your eye cream, your hydrating lotions or your serums before that, then your hydration. And then I'm okay with you putting on something with a mixture of occlusives in it and emollients. And then you always finish off with your sunscreen. Mm-hmm. Always finish off with your sunscreen. She's now putting Goop Glow lotion on, and she's doing that on top. This is not sense, and there's no sense in this. It's got mica in it, which gives it a glow. Maybe that's what she likes, this wee glow. Anyway, but it looks okay, this one, the Goop Glow lotion. I'm looking at it. It's got squalane number one ingredient. That is a star ingredient for me. Mimics your own oil, and it's great for your natural moisturization. It's got glycerin number 5. So there is good ones in here. I do quite like that. There's some at the bottom, usual volatile oils, what will be sensitive for skin, some skins, but it's okay. There's vitamin C in it. They advertise the Goop Glow lotion with this algae, spirulina maxima extract algae, this seaweedy type thing again. This is why it does smack of Miranda Kerr and her have talked about her products or something, because it sounds similar. But this is wrong, what she's saying about clean products and going on a bit too much about that. It's as if she's selling Goop, isn't it? It's as if she's what is sellers. And, you know, that's surprising to me, because you think really that with all our health and wellness, she'd be talking about it in a different way. And also, why did she not talk to someone about before she did this to say, am I doing this the right way? Because she's trying to sound as if she knows what she's talking about with ingredients and skincare and all this stuff. And it's, none of this makes sense, Gwynny. It doesn't, I'm sorry. No, it doesn't make sense. And I wish you'd talk to an esthetician, someone first, or even one of the people that has helped you make the Goop skincare brand, and talk to them about how formulations work on the skin. I do. I'm going to say to you, what she should be using is definitely something for her pigmentation. 100%. She's definitely prone to this. She should be protecting her whole upper body with sunscreen and putting a lot of it on all over, and then putting on whatever makeup she's got to put on top of that. Yeah. Yes, definitely. She wouldn't, you know, I'm not talking about the night time, but a vitamin A at night, definitely a retinol, because she's got the lines going. She definitely looks dehydrated. So I don't think, I'm telling you right now, well, it's because of her morning exercise, but she's not drinking enough water. Oh, that's funny for me to say that. So I would definitely tell her to use a vitamin C serum in the daytime, because of this pigmentation going on. I would definitely say that to her, and also because it'll help stimulate collagen. Not that she looks as if, maybe she's had a bit of work done, because her neck is beautiful for her age. It is. And her jawline, it just all looks nice and tight. But I do quite like the natural look and not too much makeup. I do think that's good. But when you're doing a skincare vid, for heaven's sake, let people see you real, Gwynny. Mm-hmm. Let people see you real. So that's it. I thought that was hilarious. Oh my God, it's going to take me a whole day to recover. I'll need to sit down after doing this one. And I'm not into all of this about slagging someone off, but someone needs to talk to Gwynny and get her to redo this. Is that going to help if she redoes it and says, I'm sorry, I made a mistake? Yes, it would help. So I hope you found that interesting, and I want you to have, if you've got any questions about your skin, feel free to put them in the comments below. You can also email me at joan@joanieloves.co.uk, and I'll help you whatever way I can. I'm always wanting to get the right information to you, and that's what my channel's about, getting the right information to you so that you can go cut through all the bullshit that's out there and marketing ploys from people that own skincare brands. Okay, so have a great week. Take care of yourselves. Look forward to seeing you again.